वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि बरकातुहू। वेलकम टू माय क्लास स्टूडेंट्स। सो टुडे आई एम टेकिंग इंग्लिश ग्रामर नाउंस। यू कैन जस्ट ओपन योर पेज नंबर 13 एंड 14, 13 इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक। सो टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट नाउंस, टाइप्स ऑफ नाउंस, जेंडर्स, काउंटेबल नाउंस एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अ नाउन? You have studied already, you have studied in your lower classes. What do you mean by noun? I'll just revise once for you. What do you mean by noun? A noun is a part of speech that names a person, place, thing, idea, action or quality. What is a noun? Noun is a part of speech that names a person, place, thing, idea, action or quality. I'll show you some picture of this. You can see in this picture, students, person. It may be any person, place. Place, it can be any place, thing or a animal. It involves quality also. It involves things also. It involves actions also in a noun. Now let us study types of nouns. Noun is divided into 5 types, that is, first noun is common noun, next proper nouns, collective nouns, concrete nouns, abstract nouns. So we'll be studying in details what do you mean by proper noun, what do you mean by common noun, proper noun, collective noun, contrive nouns, concrete nouns and abstract nouns. First of all, what do you mean by common nouns? Open your page number 13. That they have given the definition of common noun. A common noun is a name given to every person, place, animal and thing of same kind. What is a common noun? It is a name given to every person, place, animal and thing of same kind. You've seen some pictures on common noun. You can see the examples of common noun. Here it's a boy. They are specifying just boy. So it is just a common boy. It's a common noun. Next, school. They are not specifying which school it is. It is just specified school. So it's a common noun. Next, a fish. Next we'll go to proper noun. What do you mean by proper noun? The definition of proper noun is a particular name of a person, place, animal or thing. Proper noun always begins with... So, a proper noun always starts with capital letter. Here you can see GS, Taj Mahal. It is starting with a capital letter. Jupiter, Australia, Titanic, the Bible. This and all are few examples of proper noun. Next we can go to collective nouns. Collective noun. What is the definition of collective noun? It is a name of a group of people, animal or thing. It's just a group of people, thing or place, anything. Now for example there, dynasty of kings, a tribe of natives, half of lectures. These are and all example of collective nouns. Next we can go to concrete nouns. Concrete nouns are noun of those objects that we can see, touch, hear or smell. This and all which we can see, touch, hear or smell are nothing but concrete nouns. Here in the picture, nouns which you can taste, see, smell, hear or touch. Now for example, cake. You can eat the cake there. You can just feel the taste of the cake. That is example of concrete nouns. So now the last noun, that is abstract nouns. Abstract nouns are name of things that we cannot see, touch, hear, taste or smell. Abstract nouns are names of qualities. Qualities like bravery, laziness, sad, happy. Actions like robbery, laughter. You laugh, no? That and all are nothing but actions. And states like sleep, childhood, that and all comes under abstract nouns.
Now in this page number 30, the first exercise given, they have given you. Given below are some nouns. Pick them in The second is proper nouns. Third basket is collective nouns. Fourth is concrete nouns. And fifth basket is abstract nouns. As I have explained you all the five nouns, now you can just differentiate and put the correct word in correct basket. Now first word here is Rita. What is Rita? It is a proper noun. Why it is proper noun? Because it is a name of a particular name of a person. Rita. Next, cow. Cow again is a proper noun. India is a proper noun. What is this pride? Pride is a abstract noun because it tells something about feelings. It is nothing but which we cannot see, touch, hear or taste. This is pride. Next, joy. Joy again is an abstract noun. Next, keys. What are keys? Keys is nothing but collective nouns. Try to do the list by yourself. Next, we can go to genders.
So here in the picture are masculine gender and feminine gender. Masculine gender means male. Male, it is a male. Now for example, there it is a boy and grandfather. Feminine gender is female, that represent as she. So it is a girl or grandmother. Nouns that can either be masculine or feminine belong to common gender. Always keep this in mind, which are neither masculine or nor feminine, that belongs to common gender. Now in this picture you can see, now you can see in this picture the chart is given masculine, feminine and neutral. The first one there is prince, it's a boy. Next, feminine comes under princess. What is it? It's a girl or she. Next is a neutral gender, that is a thing. A thing, that is a castle or a tree, hat. You can see the things there. Okay.
Now again, they have given, complete the sentences with the nouns of genders given in the bracket. The first one is, the dash sat on their dash and zoomed down the road. Here, the dash sat on there, it is given. Here it is there. So it is many, not one. It is many. So I have written masculine, it is boy. So I have written boys. The boys sat on their cycle. Neutral gender it is a thing. And zoomed down the road. The rest you can do by yourself.
So here is another one chart. Masculine gender. What? Who is he? He is a boy. Next, feminine gender, she is a girl. Neutral gender is a thing, that is a car. The next is man, woman and a table. In masculine gender, it's father and son. Feminine gender, mother and daughter. Neutral gender, it's boat. It's a thing. Next, grandfather, grandmother in feminine gender, a tree in neutral gender. Now next we can go to countable and uncountable nouns. Open your page number 14. There they have given pairs of words. That is, first one they have given rat. That is the rat. It is a singular form. Next they have given rats. It's a plural form of rats. Chair, singular form. Plural form of chair is chairs. Knife, knives. Here they have added ES. They have added ES. Yes. Next is woman, woman. Key, keys. Plural and singular form. All these nouns which can be singular or more and they can be counted, they are called as countable nouns. All these nouns have their plural forms. Now this read, just read this words. Bread. Bread doesn't have a plural form. Jam. It doesn't have a plural form. Honey. It also doesn't have a plural form. Next, floor. Can you count these nouns? No, we can't count these nouns. Bread can't be counted. It's just a bread. Jam. It also cannot be counted. Next, honey. We can't count honey. Next floor, even this cannot be counted. There are uncountable nouns. Now let us see some examples of countable and uncountable nouns. Here in the picture, eggs. How many eggs are there? 1, 2, 3. Next is a banana. It's just one. So it is a countable noun. It's just one. Here x also is a countable noun because we can count the x. Next is olive. We can count the olive. Fries. We can also count the fries there. In uncountable noun, can milk be counted? No. It's just uncountable noun. Milk can be measured but can't be counted. Next, the floor. Salt. Salt also cannot be counted. Next, the sugar also cannot be counted. Just do the exercise by your own. That is page number 14. Next, down we have D main. Rewrite the following sentence changing the nouns to plural form. Remember to change the verbs to plural form too. This also I have explained. The first one that I'll tell. The tiger hunts for meat. Here you should just change the sentence to plural form. Tiger. It's tigers. The tigers hunts for meat. Jazakallahu khair. Please complete page number 13 and 14.